My name is Melissa Wenzel, and I'm an inspector with the Minnesota Pollution Control Agency's Industrial Stormwater Program. As you know, the Industrial Stormwater Multi-Sector General Permit requires all permittees to conduct benchmark monitoring. Today, I will demonstrate how to collect a stormwater sample using the grab sample method. The process for collecting and submitting sampling results can be broken down into six parts. Today, I will demonstrate part four, how to collect a stormwater sample using the grab sample method. At the end of this video, we'll provide links for more information on the other parts for stormwater sampling. A grab sample is a single sample and is as simple as placing a sampling bottle and flowing stormwater. Today, I will be collecting a stormwater sample from a culvert. This technique will generally work for the following locations that facilities may be collecting for, listed on the screen. If you are required to collect a sheet flow sample, be sure to check out our other video, How to Collect a Sheet Flow Sample. Make sure that you choose a time and location where stormwater is flowing. Collect the sample within the first 30 minutes of a measurable runoff event. Before you go outside, be sure to write the name of the person collecting the sample and the date the sample was collected. While wearing gloves, remove the cap from a clean bottle. You do not want to contaminate the top of the bottle. Also, do not place the lid on the ground or in your pocket. Hold the bottle so the opening is facing upstream. Take care to not disturb the bottom of the stormwater flow, or don't walk in the discharge so that you won't contaminate your sample. The collection of the sample should be as close to the middle of the stormwater flow as possible to be representative of the discharge. You'll notice that I'm not placing my fingers or hands over the top or inside the bottle when collecting the sample. Otherwise, I might contaminate the sample. Your lab should have instructed you how full the bottle should be. Fill it to the level they instructed you to fill it. If the sample bottles came with preservatives, add them now. Be careful not to spill, as preservatives are most often acids. Cap the sample bottle. Then, record the time the sample was collected. Place the samples inside a resealable plastic bag before placing the bottles into the cooler. Place the bag into a cooler and prepare the cooler according to lab instructions for pickup or shipment to the lab. Often, labs require that the samples be packed in ice to help preserve the sample. After you've taken your sample, make sure to take thorough notes on how the sampling event went and facility conditions. You might want to consider taking a photo of sampling conditions after you take your sample. This might help remind you of site conditions when filling out the monitoring report. That's it! Today I collected a stormwater sample from a culvert using the grab sample method. For more information, including the best sampling methods for your facility, visit the program's website at www.pca.state.mn.us/industrial-stormwater. Go to the What's New section to find the sampling manual. It is filled with more detailed information about all six parts of the stormwater collection process.